Venus is the closest planet to Earth and also the most similar in terms of some physical characteristics. However, this very close world is unsuitable for any life since it has a very high surface temperature. If a group of astronauts traveled to this planet and took off their suits, they would be surprised that they could not survive there for more than 5 seconds. What would happen if you took off your astronaut suit while on Venus? What would spending a whole day on the hottest planet be like? Join us on this journey of knowledge to find out. Venus is the closest planet to Earth and the most similar in size to ours. However, despite these similarities, Venus is not a planet that humans can inhabit. If humans decide to visit this planet on a crewed mission, the brave astronauts who venture into this hostile world must overcome many dangers and risks. The first challenge? Speed. Venus's orbit is 28% closer to the Sun than to the Earth. For this reason, spacecraft traveling to Venus must travel more than 41 million kilometers, entering the Sun's gravitational well and losing part of their potential energy in the process. The potential energy of spacecraft destined for Venus is transformed into kinetic energy, which increases the spacecraft's speed, which can be challenging to control. Contrary to the spacecraft that go to Mars, the spacecraft that go to Venus accelerate so much that if a group of astronauts were heading towards this planet, they would be subjected to significant accelerations that would leave them completely unconscious. So the mission would have to be entirely controlled by a computer or artificial intelligence that would put the astronauts in a safe orbit while they regain consciousness. The people who go to Venus would have to be very experienced astronauts or airplane pilots who are accustomed to sudden changes in speed so as to not become unconscious during entry into the orbit of Venus. Travel time will not be a problem since Venus is the closest planet to Earth. And during the period of closest approach, it would take a spacecraft a couple of months to reach its destination. But once they reach Venus, the difficulties will only begin. A dangerous landing. On Earth, we are very used to having a calm atmosphere, warm winds, and light rain. But it is entirely different on Venus. Before sending exploration probes to Venus, we did not know what the planet's surface was like, because the clouds were so dense that they would not allow us to see beneath them. But this changed on March 1, 1982, when the lander of the Soviet space exploration probe, Venera 13, entered the dense clouds of Venus to show us what was beneath them. Since the 1960s, the Venera probes and NASA's Mariner 2 spacecraft have given us images of the clouds that perpetually cover the atmosphere of Venus. Thanks to this, we knew which elements could be formed in the clouds and the temperatures must have had. But other than that information, we didn't know what the surface of Venus was like or what was hiding beneath those clouds. When the Venera 13 space probe finally managed to enter the clouds of Venus, we realized that the atmospheric pressure of this planet was much higher than we had imagined, almost 100 atmospheres. This is similar to the pressure a submarine feels when it dives several thousand meters beneath the ocean. Fortunately, the Venera probe managed to survive the entry and land safely on the surface of Venus to give us some impressive images of this planet. This was the first image we had of the surface of Venus. Venera 13 managed to take this image and send a lot of pressure and temperature data to Earth, but 2 hours after landing, it succumbed to the extreme pressure and temperature of Venus. Later, Venera 14 would achieve the same feat as its sister Venera 13, and in the same way would manage to penetrate the thick cloud layer of Venus to send sound recordings of this planet, as well as beneficial information for future missions. If today we wanted to replicate this mission, but with real people and not robots, difficulties would arise that would be very difficult to overcome. To begin with, the entry of a human-crewed spacecraft into the atmosphere of Venus will be dangerous. Typically, human-crewed spacecraft are not designed to withstand very high atmospheric pressures, since that pressure does not exist in space. Spacecraft such as the Venera 13 and 14 export probes could withstand these pressures and temperatures because their separate components were modified with thermal insulation and vacuum sealed with very resistant materials that allowed the electrical system and electronic devices to work for a few hours before failing. But in the case of a human-crewed spacecraft, it would not be enough to modify a few components, but the entire structure surrounding the spacecraft would have to be designed to withstand a pressure similar to that felt here on Earth at 1 kilometer away into the depth under the ocean. This means that the spaceship that will carry astronauts to Venus would have to have the resistance of a submarine. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. The difficult part is just the beginning. What's the problematic construction of a human-crewed spacecraft capable of withstanding the crushing atmospheric pressure of Venus has been solved, the most challenging stage will begin, combating the high temperatures. Remember that on Venus, temperatures can reach close to 867.2 degrees Fahrenheit or 464 degrees Celsius in the less elevated regions near the equator. This makes Venus hotter than Mercury, despite being more than twice the distance from the Sun and receiving only 25% of the solar radiation that Mercury receives. The reason for this significant difference in temperatures is that on Venus, the gases that predominate in the atmosphere are carbon dioxide, nitrogen, methane, and other gases that produce a permanent greenhouse effect. These gases retain a lot of heat, which means that the heat that reaches Venus does not leave as quickly, which keeps its surface boiling all the time. Astronauts who will venture to this place must wear suits with unprecedented thermal insulation. Firefighter suits can withstand up to 932 degrees Fahrenheit or 500 degrees Celsius before starting to deteriorate. And the suits worn by astronauts who went to the moon could withstand the same temperatures but in outer space. In other words, we currently have the technology to develop spacesuits that withstand the high temperatures of Venus. The problem then would not to be to counteract the temperatures, but to be able to design a suit that withstands those temperatures and simultaneously withstand a pressure of 100 atmospheres. As the date of this video, the highest pressure diving suit known is the exosuit, which has been able to withstand pressures up to 700 meters deep, equivalent to approximately 70 atmospheres. This suit, developed by NYCHTO Research, has been used in underwater exploration missions and is a pressurized underwater exoskeleton that allows divers to work at extreme depths. This means that the maximum pressure that we have managed to withstand with modern technology is only 70 atmospheres. We still have to go up one more step to be able to build a suit that can withstand the pressure of Venus and at the same time withstand temperatures of 932 degrees Fahrenheit or 500 degrees Celsius. For now, the spacesuits could not withstand the pressure of Venus even for 10 seconds. An astronaut who decided to abandon the ship and take a walk on Venus with the protection of his suit would not even be able to walk since the high pressure would push him to the ground as if 10 cars were on his head. He could barely lift a finger at that pressure. And once the suit suffered a crack, the temperature would begin to leak, cooking the astronaut alive in a few seconds. On the other hand, astronauts who stayed inside the spacecraft, protected from the high pressures and scorching temperatures, would not be completely safe. Rain that melts metal. On Earth, we're used to rain, bringing puddles in the streets, cool days, and water for the plants. But on Venus, when it rains, it's a sign of danger. Unlike Earth, where it rains water, it rains sulfuric acid on Venus. If you don't know it, this acid can melt different materials such as lead or metal in a few minutes. A group of astronauts inside a spacecraft designed to withstand the high temperatures and pressures of Venus would not be safe from the acid rain that would, little by little, get into the cracks of the ship, melting everything in its path, such as the power cables, electrical systems, pipes, among other systems. And if that were not enough, the cracks that the ship would suffer due to the sulfuric acid would cause the air to gradually leak from the atmosphere of Venus, which is composed of carbon dioxide, nitrogen, and methane, in addition to having other components that make that air of Venus smell like rotten eggs. Without a doubt, it would be a very unpleasant experience for astronauts. If we think about it, this means that even if we can develop a suit that can withstand the pressure and temperature of Venus in the coming years, we would also have to find a way for that suit to be immune to sulfuric acid. Quite a difficult challenge to achieve for modern technology. Today, we know that some materials are relatively resistant to sulfuric acid, such as polyvinyl chloride, also known as PVC, or polytetrafluoroethylene, better known as PTFE. Unfortunately, these materials would not withstand the high temperatures of Venus, so we could not cover the spacesuit, much less a spaceship, with these materials. Another material that can resist the sulfuric acid that rains on Venus is stainless steel, but this material is not very moldable. In addition to being very heavy, a suit lined with this material would be so rigid and heavy that if a person put it on, couldn't move. The same thing happens with a spaceship. If we coated every part of a spacecraft with stainless steel, it would be too heavy to take off. We still do not have the material to carry out this task. We will have to wait a few years until a scientist develops a new technological material that resists sulfuric acid and simultaneously withstands high temperatures and pressures without deforming. Perhaps one of the subscribers of this channel is that future scientist who develops that new material that will allow us to achieve the dream of making a suit that will allow us to walk on the surface of Venus one day. For now, the technology of our time limits us, but it is worth knowing what the future challenges will be to motivate future engineers who will be in charge of making those dreams come true. Now it's your turn. We want your thoughts. So tell us, do you think that one day we will develop the material needed to build a suit that allows us to walk on the surface of Venus? Let us know your opinion in the comments.